body of thy Son Christ, our Lord. Grant, we beseech thee, for thy holy church in paradise and on earth, thy light and thy peace.
Amen.
People get mine.
Amen.
Praise to and trust people.
Amen.
With all who have died in the hope of the resurrection to have.
Thank you. praying for our grandmother today. For her love.
for giving her to us and to her family, for her contribution to society and to humanity. We ask God to be with us through the power of the Holy Spirit, that we emulate some of the good qualities of hers and carry on the task that God has entrusted to us. Our service continued on page 11, bottom of page 11, the great thanksgiving. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who rose victorious from the dead and comfort us with the blessed hope of everlasting life. For the God, take them in remembrance that Christ died for you, and feed on him in your heart by faith with thanksgiving.
Thank you.
your servant with your sins. And we are mortal form of the earth, and to earth shall we return. For so did you ordain when you created me, saying, you are dust, and to dust you shall return. All of us go down to the dust, yet even at the grave, we make our song, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Selina Hooke, a singer of your own redeeming. Receive her into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, into the glorious company of the saints in life. Amen.
Come up and give your tribute in silence, because everybody was asked to give their tribute yesterday because of time.
Economic affairs, may please stand.
for each sunset, there is a sunrise. In a land we cannot see, there is a place of love and endless dawn that's called eternity. In this land, there are no shadows and no deepening shades of night, and no candles ever needed, for God provides the light. No pain or sorrow enters there, no teardrop ever falls, and there is no such thing as parting or separation within its golden core. Cares and worries are forgotten in this land where trials cease and the heart knows only gladness and the bliss of perfect peace. And in time there'll be reunion, sweeter far than words can say, with those who have gone on and are with us in this land of endless days.
Kakata, Magidi County, by St. Augustine's family. We are here to register our gratitude to Almighty God on this wonderful occasion, and we invite Christians in general to join us in this celebration. The late Sister Selina, Asie, Hooke, who was a founder member of the St. Augustine's Episcopal Church of Kakata, and through her life and devotion, we are thankful to God for such a unique gift. We are talking about one that could be described as no less than a hero, patriot, mother, disciplinarian, Christian, and a devoted worker. Sister Hooke was one of the few who helped to foster the dream then of Father T.J. O'Godding to erect the modern edifice of St. Augustine as we last left it in Kakata. She worked rather tirelessly along with other prominent parishioners of her time to actualize that dream, even when the means of the congregation could hardly match the challenge. Please bear with me as I recall that the Hooke family was then residing at Madingo Quarters in Kakata. The family was not well-to-do, but they just loved to invest in God's work. Good servant. Neither was she engaged with any of the concessions. She was not a product of the business school in the university, yet she provided a strong support to her husband, Brother Christian Hooke. He celebrated one which was over 50 years. Sister Selina Hooke was truly endowed with a natural flair for business. She was intelligent, and most of all, she was blessed. The modest family she mothered had 7 children, all of whom were educated to enviable heights. Furthermore, Sister Hooke sponsored countless other children through high school and university. Archbishop Whitley of Dublin once said that, and I quote, "As the flower is before the fruit, so is faith before good works." In this regard, therefore, Sister Selina Asie Hooke demonstrated in her life in Kakata commendable faith in many of her activities. But she would refuse to simply stop short. She motivated her ECW colleagues to make the insurmountable possible. It was quite a task in those days to have the ECW of St. Augustine's Calcutta represented in diocesan conventions. Members then used to contribute only 25 cents every meeting day to sponsor delegates. But the collection was never enough. It was Sister who challenged all to contribute no less than a dollar for each meeting. And that was how the problem was solved. We offer more thanks to God for the wonderful gift of Sister Hooke to the St. Augustine's congregation. Her toilsome years are now over. Her church life, which was ever so constant, even in her old age, is also over. Her pledge payments, which she always fulfilled, have now come to an end. Sister Hooke fulfilled also a final marital commitment. She supervised very ably a decent Christian funeral of her husband in 1990, while we were deep in the war. Sister Hooke eventually waded away down here to Monrovia in July 1992. We offer many thanks to Tonier. We offer many thanks to Tonier for those rights he used to give from Salala to facilitate Sister Hooke worshiping with us in Calcutta. We feel sad at the parting, but we praise God for Sister Hooke. Goodbye, sister. Farewell, mother. Sleep you well in peace. On behalf of the rector, officers, and members of St. Augustine's Calcutta, profound gratitude is extended to Canon Bride, the rector, and the St. Stephen's family for this remarkable hospitality extended to us. The St. Augustine's Calcutta family is yet in diaspora, with some members in Danane, some in the Republic of Guinea, some in the Republic of Sierra Leone, some in America, etc., etc. And many have unfortunately predeceased this great occasion. However, I extend deep condolences and congratulations to the bereaved family on behalf of St. Augustine's Calcutta. May light perpetually shine on our fallen sister, our mother. Amen.
On behalf
Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Gore Jackson.
My mother personally requested that all she wants on her birthday and on her funeral day are a lot of songs. I request now that somebody, preferably maybe in the school medicine clinic, sing one joyful song to start this tribute. She wants us to sing around her casket so she can be dancing in it. Selina Asie Hooke was born in Freetown, Sierra Leone on 24th July 1910 under the union of Mr. and Mrs. Magnus A. Campbell. Apparently we have a connection here also. She was baptized in the Anglican Church, that's where you graduated, the Episcopal Church here, in her infancy and until her demise, was an ardent worshiper in her faith. Her keen interest in uplifting the spiritual life of the St. Augustine Episcopal Church in Pakistan earned for her a certificate of recognition for invaluable contributions to the church. She attended the Cathedral School and later the Annie Walsh Memorial High School in Freetown, secondary school, in Freetown, Sierra Leone from 1914 to 1928. She always boasted of Annie Walsh. I don't know if there's a living past member of Annie Walsh Memorial High School in Sierra Leone. And we as children believe this because she was very much educated in her own way. In our communications to us, I always tell the funny story of how I was in college in the United States of America and she wrote me a letter and I devoted the dictionary to define some of those words. But she was an educated woman in her own time. Well, after school, she traveled with her late aunt, Hannah Davis, in Madison County. She became involved in business, along with her cousin, Mrs. Priscilla George, the wife of James E. George, her mother. Now, brother, told us how this engagement came about. She was living with the governors, or uncle and aunt. And Christian used to work at the post office in the Canada. And every time he passed right by the house, and each time he passed by, he noticed this beautiful lady up staring through the window. And this engagement went on and on and on and on until they encountered somehow. At that point, she did not explain. But as she went on, he finally wrote her guidance for visitation. And as she always told us about how the visitation was granted. But she always told her how it went, the dating went. That Christian would enter the house, in the living room, she would be on one side, Christian would be on one side, and the governors would be in the middle. The kids threw you out of the house, gave us the living room. There was no contact between the two until eventually they got married in 1935, April 14th. I remember she always particularly remember that day because it was the day our trouble started. So every time she would say, well, here comes April 14th again, the day I got married. This marriage was blessed with 7 children. In fact, 9. The 3 predeceased her. 2 died at birth, and 1 just died also in 1990. So we are here. There's Christian, there's Lucretia, there's Amelia, there's Anna, there's Gifted, and there's Holy. The baby. Our mother said on the last birthday, 60th anniversary. As was mentioned, she celebrated her 5th year at St. Augustine. But she didn't want to see her sister. You all took that for a joke. I also reminded my little sister, we're not little anymore, my little sister Gifted, that she also said to me when I was about 11 years old, there's a lot of things you don't remember, but why that stayed in my mind all these years, I don't know. We're standing at the window of our house we lived in Canada. At that time, it was an old town with all type groups. People never knew we lived in such house, but we did. There was not one big house in Canada. And while we're standing at the window, an old lady was passing by, and being a frisky child, I said, oh man, look at that lady. I was laughing because she was really creepy. And she slapped me on the head and said, stop your big talk, your big head. 84 years old, 3 months, 28 days. After her marriage to Christian, she engaged. My father was a businessman in this company. She worked along with him with the, what he used to call the French company, CFAO, as referred to today. That's way back then in the, you know, 20s, they started, you know, operations here. And we're in White Plains. That's when we started hand in hand doing business, but for other people. In fact, for foreigners. But in 1936, the company opened another branch in Kakata. And that's what carried my mother and her husband to Kakata. They went to manage the French company in Kakata. I think if it's not destroyed today, we have not taken the survey, that building still stands, because before the war, it was still standing there. In 1940, that business closed, and they decided to open their own business. The chief, the most powerful chief in Calcutta those days, old lady Lanko Lippi, gave my father a parcel of land. So they settled there and opened a business. They were there with other people like the Talbots, the Goodings, the Brights, the Piers, the Smiths, the Betts, name all the business, Liberian business people those days. They all were trading in Calcutta. In fact, my old man always jokes, say, oh, Bartlett did well, he never allowed Lebanese to come back here. Only Liberians were here those days. After a while, they left, after being in Calcutta for many years, they left to pursue a more business, lucrative business of construction. By that time, the roads were bad, there were practically no roads up in the interior. But eventually, they were hard-working people. They woke up at 5 o'clock in the morning, and they pursued their business affairs. So they proceeded from Calcutta to Weyala. Those of you who were in Weyala at the time will know that they lived there for some time. In fact, besides our oldest brother, all of us was born when we moved to Calcutta, to Weyala. And after a while, in 1949, they settled in Salalah and made that place the final rest, Salalah Bangkandu. As you can see from the program, she is there with paramount chiefs, with commissioner, with educational and sergeants, sitting there with her husband right behind her, attending one of those Flag Day celebrations. Those days, we said, now Salalah is gone, because remember Salalah is old, because people like our parents, especially my mother, was deeply involved in all aspects, in all aspects of life in Salalah. Now, I'd like to correct a mistake. I know the mistake is in the chapter came up here and said she never said Selina. But she never told people that she was a Selina. But the Ministry of Education authorities will be aware that my mother was employed as a chief dietitian. Chief dietitian in 1959 for the newly constructed Martha Tubman Elementary Demonstration School. In fact, it was the only public job she held. And it was a great job because we tend to look at these kinds of jobs as menial jobs. But she brought gladness for many school children. She fed them well and she felt good. One of the children she read said yesterday, nobody complained. And when the school authorities held back the food, she served them well and served all of it that she got to distribute. After that, she retired in 1974. During my mother's lifetime also, she was active in the social and humanitarian work of Bong County. All of the middle age and cared for everyone. Our house was open to all. The poor, the rich, the educated, the uneducated. All of them. During the late President Tubman's administration, she was very active in promoting the suffrage of women and was particularly interested in the participation of women in developmental activities, raising projects around the country. She You always told how to slap his. Those children that my mother read, I cannot name them at this time, because there are very many. Very many, even before I was born, were grandchildren, and I don't know how many I went through. So I don't want to take this time to name them one by one. But if some of you are here, please stand up. Children that were bred by this funeral was in Selina. If this funeral was in Selina, you would have seen more on the Papa side, you would have seen more and more of this. Our mother died on November 21, 1994, at the St. Joseph County Hospital after going through 5-day coma as a result of a stroke. I was home around in the morning when my sister sent to me and said, come and see Grandma. Yeah. Obviously, I got a message. I was about to go in the bathroom. I just left with my slippers, everything, because I want to see why I must come and see Grandma so early in the morning. I met her, couldn't speak, couldn't talk, she was just flat. But she was breathing, and we had hope. We immediately summoned the ambulance and took her to the hospital. Well, it seemed like my mother wanted to go the easy way and relieve us of the burden. She always said that she didn't want to be bothered with people doing things for her. She wanted to be able to help herself, to take a bath, to change her clothes, and cook. She and Amelia always fussed on Sunday about who to cook at 84 years old. And they are both stubborn. And the last meal she wanted to cook, I wish she had done it, because when I got there that afternoon, she said, well, I wanted to cook, but Amelia said you should rest. We're not feeling too good. And she cooked the jollof rice I sent to you, Amelia cooked it. She was a good cook. I want to thank members of the family, especially Amelia, who took care of her in these last days. I was with her all through the war, beginning from her country. She went through some sorrowful experiences. In fact, she arranged the funeral, but she was not even able to attend it, my father's funeral. She was so ill that she couldn't even lie in the bed. She sat up day and night. I remember that morning she called me and said, there was shooting around the house the day before. And my father had a stroke, the same situation she died from. And she said that morning, after he had a stroke that night, over 10, and put him to bed. And she said to me that morning when I came to visit the room, 6:30 that morning, said, Uncle Sam, look at your father. He said, I've not heard him talk since 2 o'clock, because all through the night we talk. I've not heard him talk since 2 o'clock. And the last thing I heard him say, oh death, where is thy sting? Oh grave, where is thy grave? He said his own funeral. He says, Sam, please look at him. And when I took off his covers, I said, oh mom, that's it. He's finished. She just couldn't believe it. So she went through hardship. She went through the bullets. There were 8 year-olds stood before her in the village. And the command was, blow this house down. She must do that. En route to Phoebe, when she was sent for, by the Fiji administration. And Swakoko, she was stopped. Guy jumped before her, had the gun before her. My two little girls jumped through the window. Gunshot was fired at my ear. I can say we survived that because we're a very strong family. Very strong with courage. In fact, we are so strong that so forgive us. We got it from this beautiful lady. She happily sang, she raised all the songs. She raised all the songs that night and was singing heartily. And the last song that she sang was Take My Life. And everything. So can we sing a verse of that?
Mm. and wanted natural flowers because there was nothing artificial about you. Very simple human being. How about you?
Thank you.
whose blessed soul were laid in the sepulcher in the garden, bless, we pray, this grave, and grant that she, whose body is to be buried here, may dwell with Christ in paradise and may come to your heavenly kingdom through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Everyone the Father gives to me will come to me. Everybody is here. I will never turn away anyone who believes in me. He will raise Jesus Christ from the dead. We also give new life to our mortal bodies through his indwelling spirit. My heart therefore is glad and my spirit rejoices. My body also shall rest in hope. You will show me the path of life. In your presence there is fullness of joy. In your right hand are pleasures forevermore. In sure and certain hope, we commend to Almighty God our dear mother, Selina. We commit her body to the ground. Ashes to ashes, dust to dust. The Lord bless her and keep her. The Lord make his face to shine upon her and be gracious to her. The Lord lift up his countenance upon her and give her peace. Amen. We sing after the commission. We sing with you. Christian dance. You have the page, Sleep On, Beloved Sleep, the Christian Good Night.
Now shall we no mortal toil and win. This is a frightful blessing, your and deep. Good night, good night, good night, good night, good night.
Amen.
Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, who by your death took away the sin of death, grant to us, your servants, so to
pray. And none be missing. Lord, now let us our servants depart in peace according to thy word.
Oh,
This has been a production of the Harley Room Video Incorporated. Bill and Ross the Third, managing partner.
No, nothing I can hear.